Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Land Plays, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We are still one item and one incredibly unlikely series of events away from getting real Platinum God, I think. Maybe some secret room items? I can't recall. But for now, that last blue baby run, exhilarating, good way to start the day. We're also going to have a Cain run. I like Cain. I don't like starting on the cellar unless it means that we fight the haunt on this floor and thus give ourselves a pretty good deal with the devil chance on the next floor. Y6EJ. Sate Quer. QR. Again, if there's one happy side effect of this Binding of Isaac Rebirth series and the fact that I'm writing down these seeds on this post-it note, it's, man, my penmanship has actually gotten legible for the first time in years. I don't think I have written anything on a piece of paper except for my own, you know, signature on checks and stuff like that, because I'm a big shot. I still use checks up here. Yeah, oh, business, man. Since, like, I was a teacher, and even then, it was like, you pretty much, you're just circling errors and then being like, see me after class. Anyway. Not that all teachers write that little. I was, you know, glorified daycare overseas. Anyway. If you think about it, school is, in a way, just glorified daycare to begin with, at least for young kids. I'm not trying to say that what I did was not important, but, you know, it was largely like, hey, if we can pay our kids, or if we can pay for our kids to go to daycare, or we can pay to our kids, or pay for our kids to go to daycare and, you know, perhaps learn something in the process. You know, they're young, their brains are sponges, they won't even notice that they're learning. It's a good thing. Now, Cain. What are the essences of any Cain run? Not dying on the first floor is a big one, so I'm actually gonna, you know, play it safe, go to our item room first. Which is not gonna be anywhere close by. We are gonna have to go through that big room. Which always worries me. Of all the big rooms that I hate, the worst big rooms are the chest, the dark room, and the fucking basement and cellar. Just because you're so unlikely to have the tools necessary to really deal with them. Four keys is great. And this is not one of the worst rooms. The absolute worst rooms, at least, that you can get here, but it is a bad one. That was very nearly a hit there. As long as you only create, like, one corridor here, a couple of corridors, you can usually sneak in enough kills that you don't have to be nervous about the rest of the room, but there are some much worse rooms in this. Oh, come on. I hate those enemies. Will we go to the curse room on the first floor? It is plausible if we get a red heart. And we get sad bombs, which is actually glorious, so here's what I'm thinking. We come in here. Okay, pills. That's gonna open that for me. Oh, that Eternal Heart is gonna be very difficult to get, isn't it? Don't give me Bad Trip. If you get Bad Trip, I'll die. Oh my god. We get Speed down and Tears down there. We can get that Eternal Heart, maybe. It depends on how this Tinted Rock right here works out. Okay, it gives us two Spirit Hearts. Which means we can pick these up. I'll fight the boss first, just to be sure. And this looks like it could work out okay. Sad Bombs is a great item, I love it. And the ability for us to get one extra HP compensates slightly for the Tears downgrade. The Speed downgrade, if that's what it was, I can't remember. I don't really care about. And you can tell I don't care about it, because I don't even remember what the heck it was, but we, certainly not every roll that we took here, in a metaphorical sense, ended up being a roll that we would have wanted to take, but, overall, that curse room will be alright for us, and the fact that we got two Spirit Hearts out of our, Tinted Rock there is extremely important. Maybe it was a range down. I feel like my range might be a little lower, but, hey, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all, because we have a very good chance of snagging this deal with the devil now. Blue Cap is great. The Tears upgrade will compensate for our Tears downgrade. The Shot Speed downgrade hurts a little bit, but not very much. And let's look for our secret room. It actually is usually gettable on the first floor now. And we picked up an extra key as a result of that. You could argue that maybe we should go play that key beggar there, but I'm gonna hazard a guess and say that that is not the correct answer to whatever conundrum we might be having right now. And yeah, okay, I'll be content and say that this floor is actually pretty solid. Six keys, two HP upgrades, probably, you know, right around even with our Tears. But the HP upgrades are huge if I can get those Spirit Hearts to survive to the next floor. And since we're on the basement, that seems pretty dang likely. Alright. Less concern now. That was not good damage if we're trying to keep our Spirit Hearts alive. Also means that the Curse Room is now officially off the table for now. Until we beat our boss. Probably would not have gone to it right away anyway, but, you know. Now we know for sure. Item rooms right there off the bat. I like these semi-like linear floors here. Looks like the curse room won't be accessible via a bomb, which means it's really, really off the table. But the boss trap room might be accessible via a bomb, and if we could get like a guppy item, that would be nice. That happens all the time in those boss trap rooms. Mulligan, great item. Officially, we are past the threshold of me being able to complain. The C threshold, if you will. Too many good items. Even though we did have that slight negative. Oh my god. Even though we did have that slight negative. Now any complaining that I could make would pretty much fall on deaf ears, I think. In our mob trap room. Oh, we got four freaking troll bombs. GG. Game hates me. Oh, we just picked up another Eternal Heart. Okay. Yeah, this is legitimately some trademark Northern Lion luck happening right now. I guess the fly generation doesn't seem to be based on your luck stat. Because with the luck foot, we might be expecting... I say might because I'm not totally familiar with the mechanics of it, but... we might be expecting flies to spawn way more often than this. But maybe... maybe it's just a flat, you know, like 25% or something to generate a fly on hit, or flat 15%, I don't know. Am I gonna take this Eternal Heart right off the bat? I mean, it would be stupid to take it, so I'm just gonna leave it for now, but I wanted to take it because sometimes it would be stupid not to take it because I'll just forget about it. Anyway, very good stuff. We are gonna be a little slower than your average run, but we've picked up enough damage upgrades to, you know, realistically presume that we'll be doing a little, we'll be going a little faster on future floors. We did kind of, you know, we took more steps towards due diligence than we normally do on these early floors. Normally, I don't touch mob trap rooms or boss trap rooms this early. Oftentimes, at least. Not that it's a hard and fast rule, just generally it doesn't seem to be worth the time and the potential investment. We definitely want to go to our shop, though. Yeah, this run can set us up amazingly. We even generated another fly to take into the next room. You know, red patch, is it worth a key? Sure, why not? Humbling Bundle this early is an incredible item. Humbling Bundle at all is an incredible item, but this early is just out of control. We even have one more Spirit Heart, or hopefully Spirit Heart. No, it's a golden chest, but the golden chest paid out with Cricket's Head, which is much better than a Spirit Heart, and we are just not going to take this pill for now, just in case it botches us here, you know, gives us a bad trip or something like that. So, we're in out-of-control luck here. This we put a brick on the gas pedal of luck, and here we are. Pageant Boy, largely meaningless. And I will take Brother Bobby, just because we can afford to take Brother Bobby and still be fine. So, a Humbling Bundle actually made it so that we can pick up Remote Detonator if we want to. I don't think I really want to, though. I think I'd rather just wait till the next floor. And we're going to be out of this floor by roughly 7 minutes. I'm going to go to our curse room. So maybe we'll buy a spirit art from our shop if we can. Our luck's been so good that we might as well, you know, try this out. Tears down. Pheromones. That's all right. We'll see what this pill is in just a second. I want to crack over here and get this first. I can see forever. Well, that'll let us find a second secret room. Just wanted to see if maybe it was up there. And maybe we'll pick up... I mean, anything but another Eternal Heart would be the best possible outcome for us there. Because we already have half of one that's going to be filled here. Ah, there it is over there. So 7:30 is more a reasonable amount of time for us to get out of here. That's fine. You know, it is what it is. Brother Bobby, not a good pickup for us. But Cricket's Head, the Mulligan, Humbling Bundle, a great pickup for us. There is no Spirit Heart to buy. So the only negative thing I could say about this floor is that we are in a position where we need to find our shop or a Tinted Rock as early as possible on the next room in order to, you know, give us a little bit of peace of mind when it comes to getting a deal with the devil. It's Curse of the Unknown. Certainly, though, being without Spirit Hearts is not an adequate negative compensation for picking up Cricket's Head and the Mulligan on the same floor. I guess the other negative is we traded 1 HP for Brother Bobby, but hey, there's another Eternal Heart right there. Now, that was actually a pretty stupid mistake on my behalf there. Because there's no reason for us to pick up an Eternal Heart right off the bat. Stand a pretty good chance to lose it, unfortunately. But all we need to do, and maybe this gives me an extra incentive to just make sure that I'm picking up a Spirit Heart as soon as possible in order to make sure that life is good here. If we get to our shop, we should be able to buy whatever we want. That should create a bridge, yeah. Money's not going to be an issue, presumably, thanks to Humbling Bundle. These blue ones might explode into bullets. One of them already did. The other one just faded gently into that good night. More keys. Guppy's Tail would be a huge pickup for us now. And it is conceivable that, you know, considering this is the catacombs? Caves. Considering this is the caves, it's conceivable we get through the whole thing without taking damage. You know, whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. That's been my philosophy for the past, you know, 10 minutes. Good stuff. We are entering into a little bit of a danger zone up here. There we go. Let's just beat our boss and then hopefully be able to trade some stuff away and a deal with the devil. Keep in mind, we have 4 hearts plus... Oh, that little dip almost got me there. 4 hearts plus a half eternal heart, if I remember correctly. So that will be of some serious importance when it comes to considering whether or not we're going to be doing deals with the devil that we come across. There's no 3 heart, red heart deals. 3 red heart deals, probably a better way to simplify that. Good stuff, very easy fight. We do get a deal with the devil, so now we can take as much damage as we want, although I'd rather not. This one's a bit of a shit show. I'm going to take Sacrificial Dagger, and sometimes people get on my case for not taking Whore of Babylon, but I think given the amount of HP we have, it's somewhat unlikely that we're ever going to be able to use Whore of Babylon effectively, and I'm not taking Sacrificial Dagger as a concession. I actually think Sacrificial Dagger is a great item. Especially now, it functions as an orbital and does damage, and it does a lot of damage, so I like it quite a bit, actually. And I like Whore of Babylon as well, but the only time it would be useful for us is if we picked up Guppy's Paw. Probably. Or just never got HP and just traded it all away. Hive Mind is good. Look, there's the D4 in the item room there. I'm not going to take it. I know that's going to rub a lot of people the wrong way. I guess we'll take it and just stick with it, but... our run is already so good. I don't want to be the guy who's throwing away a great run to use the D4 every single time here. I know I've talked about how my number one commitment is to absurdity, but I am also just trying to get better at Isaac at the same time. And if we had a run that was not the world's luckiest run, I would re-roll it. Since we have the world's luckiest run thus far, I don't want to touch it. I don't want to mess with it, you know? I will say that since we've been to our item room in our shop, I think we can just go. Yeah, I think we can justify just leaving. I'll check for a secret room quickly. That's disappointing. What about here? Probably unlikely. Oh, never mind. No bad trip. I found pills. Tears down. I can see forever. That's good for the next floor. And are you a wizard? That sucks. But was it worth 3 bombs in order to pick up I can see forever? Yeah, I mean, it probably saved us 3 bombs on the next floor, so I'll enjoy it. Catacombs 2, Curse of Darkness. I'm taking it with us just in case we ever feel the need to reroll everything. Now, we still have Are You a Wizard active here. Free Curse Room is nice. We get a Spirit Heart and Goat Head, which is actually awesome. Still Are You a Wizard. I like with the eye patch, we only shoot diagonally in one direction. That's kind of cute, actually. So we will, via I Can See Forever. Can we bomb our way through here? Yes, okay. Man. It doesn't matter, really, that we took... Spirit Heart damage there because we have the Goat Head. I mean, it doesn't matter if you take Spirit Heart damage anyway, but it makes it more likely that you're going to take Red Heart damage. Get a Tears Downgrade. If we could just get the PhD in our shop. Our rotation is not blowing the doors off right now, but I do think we have a I Can See Forever for the next floor. And a Range Upgrade. Good hype. What do you got for me? What do you got for me? The Haunts. Kind of a tall order for this early, but shouldn't be too bad for us. Oh, itchy nose. Rough damage. Doesn't really matter. I think it's worth it for the I Can See Forever pill, honestly. Shoot. Shoot, 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 shoot. Shoot. Yeah, perfect timing so that we can then do that. And oh, the places you'll go. Fantastic. Let's move along here. I don't see any tinted rocks. Room's a little dangerous. Not the end of the world, though. And we were able to go to 2 special rooms. And those rooms, well, not those rooms, but the boss trap room specifically, took us a long time. So it might be seeming like we're a little slow here, but largely that's a result of the fact that we've had some, you know, pretty ambitious rooms to encounter right off the bat. Now we can start moving a little bit more quickly. It is, I always have a bad habit of, like, walking out and thinking, like, that bomb's gonna be done by the time we come back in. I can understand how, you know, I would think that would work in theory, but it does not work in practice at all. and it always ends up costing me a little bit of time. I think we're better off with Master of Unlocking. How did I miss that earlier? Machine Gun Jubblies, how did I miss those? Yeah, well, I mean, it's a bit wasteful, that's fine, though. An arcade, huh? There's some magic to be had in an arcade if we find a Demon Judgment. Without Spirit Hearts, a little anxious about it, but, you know, we can feel pretty confident. There's no Demon Judgment, though, so I'm not even going to play it, even though there was that half heart on the ground. I want to go a little bit quicker here, because we are possibly throwing our chances of the Boss Rush Room. And I haven't been to the Boss Rush Room in forever, and I think it gives me the best chance of getting the Godhead. By the way, I'm pretty confident that we actually could get the Godhead on a D4 reroll. But I don't know, I feel too much pull for the win now. I've become that which I've hated, you know? I'm the dude who's not sacrificing his high-quality run for a chance at getting that item, but I don't believe we can reroll into Cube of Meat. Like multiple cubes of meat. If we can, what we should do, okay, I'll tell you what we will do. If we keep our our D4 for the whole run, which our damage is fine enough that I don't think that's necessarily that unlikely. If we keep it for the whole run, then I will reroll after we beat Blue Baby. Bad trip, huh? Alright. We're not going to be out of here until like 15 minutes, so our odds of getting to Boss Rush are almost nil. But we are going to get Deals with the Devil every single floor. That's bad damage. Champion's Belt is a worthwhile pickup. I don't think we need the Spirit Heart, honestly. Like, now that we are getting Deals with the Devil every single floor anyway, who cares about the Spirit Hearts? The Champion's Belt will give us a little bit of extra damage, which is, like, by far the biggest predictor of success, as long as you have some HP to go along with it. There's an Eternal Heart. We'll pick that up at the end. We picked up, like, 5 HP via Eternal Hearts thus far, which is just ridiculous. Pop up. Pop up. Yep. Sacrificial Dagger paying for itself pretty easily there. And what do you have for me? Okay. It could be fine. Pandora's Box on Caves 2 is actually fine. Gives us a boss item, plus some Spirit Hearts. So we get Coat Hanger for a Tears upgrade. We'll go back and get that Eternal Heart. And again, this is just a very, very comfortable run. A little slower than I'd like. But in being slower, it's, you know, doing our due diligence has certainly worked out for us here. Getting that Goat Head for free. Incredibly nice. All right. Pop this right away. Necropolis 1. If you want to sacrifice your life and go a little faster here, by all means. We have the opportunity to just leave this floor as soon as we found it, basically. Lost half a Spirit Heart, but no big deal. At least we can get a deal with the devil right off the bat here. Alright, that was actually really good. I don't like the creep. Don't jump, don't jump, don't jump, don't jump. I'm safe. We're fine. Bloat's dead. Squeezy, a decent pickup. Normally very good, but decent for us, I'd say, in our current situation. Lump of Coal. Yes, okay. So that is very lucky for us. Now, we only took like 50 seconds on this floor, but I don't think I want to skip all of our item rooms and shops. I'd rather at least get to one of them, like whatever one is closest. We got pretty lucky with our layout here. And I don't know, I'm so ignorant of public opinion. I don't know if people would rather I go to the Boss Rush Room, or I would rather they would rather I do my due diligence on this floor, or if they'd rather I just do whatever the hell I want. That's probably the majority, you know? A lot of people are very easygoing about it. I mean, this run is looking extremely likely to be a win either way. Ah, there's our item room, so we'll just go after we kill this ding-dong right here. I don't even care too much about the damage that I took there. Bob's Curse is fine. Yeah, we'll have 3.5 minutes. Fuck those keys, I don't need them. And I don't mean this, but fuck BFF as well. You know what? I did not mean to use that second key. I was after I said fuck BFF, I was like, I don't mean that BFF. Maybe we could get you. There's options, but there's options not that meaningful for us in the later game, which is what we're rapidly approaching here. With our damage, I mean, you can see that we're shitting on these bosses, so we could quite conceivably take the enemies in our boss rush room. This room usually has no enemies in it. Fortunately, we have no way of knowing whether we're going in the right direction or not, but it shouldn't matter. 3 minutes, if you're going fast, is normally enough time, at least to have a pretty good chance of getting to your boss rush room. I don't think Anzus actually does anything for us if we have Curse of the Lost, which there's a lot of unfortunate trinkets and whatnot like that. But look, I'm not going to that. I stepped on the creep and used the rune for reasons unbeknownst. I think it just rerolls the stuff on the ground. Yeah, that was really stupid. I just mashing the keys like a dumb animal, basically. Sure, I'll open this because I don't care about the amount of time that I spend on this floor, apparently. We are getting a little tight. A little tight for time. I guess we'll go to the right. No, we've already been to the right, haven't we? Yes. It's pheromones. I don't need that. Explicitly, at least. Careful. I think we are still going to be quick enough. I hate this creep, though. It's so long-lasting. 18 minutes. I'd say we have probably about a minute and 40 seconds to get to our boss. We could beat our boss in 20 seconds. If I sacrifice... Oh, that's really nice that we found these rooms right away. If I sacrifice some HP to just get right in there with Sacrificial Dagger, we could probably do a little better. Blue map, fine for secrets. I like it. Like it well enough, at least. Spider Bite, again. It was great on the last run. I see no reason why it can't be great on this run as well. And there's our boss room. Oh, we have tons of time. Tons of time. Please. 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 Thank you. All right. 1830. Absolutely, like, a staggering amount of time. We are wrecking face. Fight is over already. We will take the Polaroid to have a better Godhead chance. We'll take Guppy's Hairball because we have a lot of HP. Not because I think we have a great chance of becoming Guppy, but can hurt. And Crystal Ball, Blue Baby's Only Friend, Super Bandage, Dark Bum. I kind of wanted to... I took Crystal Ball off the table early. Because I was like, I would like to keep the D4 and maybe use it after Blue Baby just for shits and giggles. Which is not really conducive to having a great run, necessarily, but, you know, we'll keep some semblance of absurdity alive. Crystal Ball was probably the smart play there. Dark Bomb was probably the second smartest play from, like, a safe standpoint. Even though we won't get that many Red Heart drops. But when we do get Red Heart drops, we'll get a lot of them thanks to Humbling Bundle, so never mind. We'll probably do fine in that category. What was my other reasoning in there? I'm trying to think. What else was there? I almost took Super Bandage, because I was like, you know, Super Bandage is just like... Would you rather have Super Bandage or not have Super Bandage? You'd rather have Super Bandage, no doubt about it. The other thing that's worth noting is, you know, it should be a fairly easy room for us, and in the process, we will get probably more Spirit Arts than we lose, or as many Spirit Arts as we lose. Hopefully, as a result of having Dark Bomb, plus we'll get a free item at the end. That was my thinking, at least. To some extent, that was my thinking. Alright, you are straight up done. Is there Blighted Ovum on the boss rush room? I don't seem to recall. That would be, like, the most annoying enemy. Maybe there's Blighted Ovum on the champion boss rush room, which you get if you fight a multicolored version of Mom. I don't know. We just have, like, an enemy spawn, or despawn and then spawn again? On the usual. Yeah, that's the main thing I'm trying to do here. That was bad damage, but my main MO here is, if I can have an enemy get slowed and then run in there with Sacrificial Dagger, that's great for me. Now, I am actually in a position, I wouldn't say I'm getting nervous about our lack of HP, but it is starting to present itself as a mild concern. Oh, that was just awful. We could just do as much damage to Monstro 2 as soon as possible. Then we're just fighting Gish. This would be the ultimate throw if I actually blew this one. Because we're in such a good position right now. No Mom's Knife, no Brimstone, but pretty much as close as you can come to just, like, shitting on the game without having those items. Just don't throw it by giving up this position that we put ourselves in. Yeah, Pin doesn't stand a chance there. I think we have the bloat now, maybe. That is not the bloat. I should not have been standing there, but hey, We're lucky that it was the husk, otherwise we would have taken way more damage. And the other thing is we can actually use D4 in a bit of a novel strategic way. If we... it might be worth it. I don't know. If we find ourselves in a truly terrible position where we just have no HP, we can just reroll our whole run, and it'll usually give us some HP back in return. Now, it might give us, you know, Dr. Fetus no damage. But it might not. Might give us, you know, Mom's Knife Proptosis. Can't say for sure either way. Man, what I would not give for Sagittarius or any other kind of penetrative shot at the end of this room. We're already on the horseman, which is awesome. One, like, a half rotation of Sacrificial Dagger is enough to take these horsemen out for the most part. Now, if we can just get death done a little faster, that would be awesome. Let's generate some flies here, maybe. I wanted to have, like, a little fly army ready for death. Okay, there's scythes. Scythes are the worst part, but they won't be generated anymore, and death is dead. Just got to deal with the horse now, and the horse is there. Now we got war. Okay, good. War's going to get in his permanent walking state soon. Not even going to have a chance to get close. Now we're going to try to get the Fallen done quickly. Again, Sacrificial Dagger is so good. Let's drop a Bob's Curse Bomb in there. One, both are dead, actually. And Headless Horseman's done. A little bit more strategy than I normally employ on that final wave there, but I was getting a little anxious about our HP. We're fine, though. And we get Attack Fly, which, truth be told, decent item. No Red Heart drops. That's a little shitty, but I don't know. I thought maybe we'd have Red Heart drops in there or something. No Tinted Rocks. Down to the next floor. People may have made different decisions there. That is totally fine. That's why I put the seed in the description, so we can all play along together if you super take issue with the decisions that I make on a run. But this is an incredibly good run. The Ansu's Vision Rune. Ah, right. I was like, we have Book of Secrets. Or actually, that's not what I was thinking. At first, I was like, why are we able to see everything? It's because we have Book of Secrets. This room has some very much compromised vision here. Why didn't I get two nickel drops there? Not that I'm greedy about it, we don't need the money, but I would have thought, thanks to Humbling Bundle, we would have gotten it. That should be, yeah, good payout. I don't really care if Dark Bomb gives me the occasional spider payout, positive or negative. Now, I might feel differently if that payout ends up being what cements my death, but I still think it's such a good item. I think it was worth doing Boss Rush. I thought it was going to be worth it immediately. It looks like it's maybe going to be more worth it in the long term, but I'm still extremely happy to take it. And I would take this on a deal with the devil if it showed up and I had any reservations about my overall amount of HP. I still think, oh, I'm Lord of the Flies? I didn't even realize I was Lord of the Flies. I didn't have to use as many keys or bombs as I already did. Okay, Lord of the Flies kind of sucks. Like, as far as transformation goes, it's like Guppy is like septuple A. And then Lord of the Flies is like a C+. But it is nice to get that free ability to fly. I can't lie. That's the best thing about it. Now, when the enemy spawns flies, like when if we're fighting Blue Baby and Blue Baby spawns flies or Isaac spawns flies, that will give me those flies, which is nice. Okay, this is very good. I appreciate those spirit hearts. And the Empress, huh? Let's save Ansu's instead. I found pills. Pheromones. I can see forever. Might as well pop that. Save us some bombs. And we're going to take other runes with us anyway. Or other pills. Found pills. Tears down. Wow. Not that this is terrible, but man, a PhD would have been so good for us in this run. I'll go back for that. I just wanted to get down here because you never know what the second secret room might entail. And because we used an I can see forever pill to get to it, might as well, you know, make it ours, you know? That Dingle doesn't stand a chance in hell. Cool. So with Goathead, we got one more deal with the devil coming. We got one Guppy item. You know what? I'm going to pick that up so we can get to a half heart interval. It might not matter. It might be better to just have more spirit hearts, but because it doesn't matter, it doesn't matter. That's my assumption. So we're going to stand roughly right here. Make it conceivable that we could hit with the attack fly, but not Sacrificial Dagger. Mr. Fred is dead. Fred's dead, baby. Okay, HP, not super important at this point. And three more red chests. Truth be told, I actually like having the spirit hearts, but certainly, yes, that could have been better. Down to the next floor, then. We'll save Anzus for the chest, I'm guessing, unless we get something really good, and then maybe we'll use it on the cathedral or even on this floor. Looks like we're probably going to the right here. Yeah, this, the direst this run ever looked was right before we went into that first curse room on the first floor. Or maybe before we popped open that tinted rock. And after that, it looked a little dire on the boss rush room. But since then, this run has been fantastic. I feel almost no risk of death here. Which is the perfect level of cockiness to just be totally fucked. But I'm pretty sure that's not going to happen. What are you doing, Greed? Who are you trying to impress here? You're in for a rough time. The Hermit. Not very good for us. I hope that Dark Bomb actually picked up the HP that was sitting on the floor in that last room. Yeah, okay, he's good. He actually has the intelligence to go pick it up even while we're fighting. There is a Spirit Art back there. Unfortunately, we can't benefit from it, but it's nice to know that if we take damage, we can just go get it. I'm following the standard rule, by the way, of go to the second boss or second secret room, and that'll usually give you your boss room situation. So yeah, I made a bold decision. I took 9 lives. 9 lives in the late game is absolutely the worst time to take 9 lives, but that doesn't mean it's bad. My hope is that we will be able to become Guppy here. And what's really hilarious about this is that we already kind of have all the benefits of becoming Guppy. You know, we have the mulligan, and we have the ability to fly. But I actually, like, I feel like most people understand that 9 lives is good. Plus, we were getting Eternal Hearts on every floor, so I guess I can't really complain about HP. But, I feel like most people recognize that 9 lives is awesome, but ever since I heard Nick and Josh shit-talking it, I feel like I'm part of this, like, 9 lives, you know, Truth and Reconciliation Committee or something like that, where I'm just, like, I'm doing awareness work that is, like, make sure you know, check it out, 9 lives even in the late game can be useful. If you gave me the choice between 3 HP, like, we're right before Blue Baby, and I could either have 3 HP or pick up 9 lives and have 1 HP 9 times, I would probably rather have 1 HP 9 times. I mean that sincerely. When you get to 4 HP, alright, in that situation I would probably rather have 4 HP than 9 lives. But, you know, we're also in a situation where we have Dark Bum. So, it might not be the right decision. Like, the decision I made might not be the right decision. But it's the decision that I made, and it's working out just fine. We're already almost back to the HP cap. So this is almost certainly going to go down as a win here. Not that exciting of a win, but, you know, that's all right. Not every game can be the Super Bowl. Sometimes you just have, like, you know, 45-0 blowouts, right? Those are worth as much as the Super Bowl. Well, they're not at all worth as much as the Super Bowl, but for the purposes of this analogy, those are worth as much as the Super Bowl. Not good. One more regular Wrath. Mr. Boom. Technically better than a spacebar item we're not going to do anything with, but I'm going to do something with it. I'm going to reroll it and get the freaking D100. I guarantee it. That is really mathematically irresponsible of me, but I guarantee it. I think it counts, too. Like, if you get the... If you get an item as Eden, it counts. So, you know, why not if you get an item on a ridiculous reroll? I don't see why not. That's all I'm saying. This should be a shortcut to the boss if we're following the standard rule of second boss or second secret room equals boss room in quick succession. Certainly feeling a lot better about this Dark Bum pickup ever since this floor, or ever since I took 9 lives. Oh, another vision rune, okay. They're probably like one of the rarest runes that I've had in my runs. To have so many show up at the same time is kind of comical. That's the third one we've had on this run. Just standard deviation, random chance, I guess. Should go to our second secret room. We already know what's in our second secret room, you know. It's going to be an Eternal Heart, of course, because it's always an Eternal Heart, apparently. I'm having a little bit of a problem against Isaac here, and I'm not sure why. Did I lose all of my Isaac skills all of a sudden? Even still, even with this... miasma of my own despair here, I feel like we're gonna be totally fine. Even if we die and have to respawn, you know, we have Humbling Bundle. Anytime we find a room with a Gluttony, if you kill that Gluttony last, that's going to be worth like 2 Spirit Hearts. Well, probably like 1.5 as a result of Dark Bomb Humbling Bundle. Plus, we have all the items that we're going to get on the chest. Plus, if things get really shitty, we can just reroll it with the D4. What did I tell you? This is, at this point, I can't even be like too thrilled about it because it's just ridiculous. But I am thrilled about it, and it is just ridiculous. Alright, good chests. I mean, we can open as many as we get, basically. Rosary is fine, Spider Baby's fine. Eve's Mascara, I think, is really good. And we're saving the Rosary just in case we need a little bit of an HP boost for our final boss fight. So our spiders are going to do so much damage. As you can see, we might as well use this Ansu's Rune. It's not going to do anything, but we might as well use it. Our spiders are going to do so much damage. We're going to be generating less flies, but the flies will do more damage as a result of Eve's Mascara. I believe Eve's Mascara is double damage for a tears and shot speed downgrade. It only says shot speed, but, you know, my rate of fire is lower. But the damage probably more than compensates for it. I hope. That's why I like picking it up anyway. If it doesn't, then we can stop with it. Alright, I'm an idiot. Remember what I was talking about with Gluttony earlier. The trick is you do have to kill Gluttony last. You can't just, you know, blow him out of the way right off the bat. So the Rosary, in its own weird way, is like a bad item that guarantees us a win. It's the most valuable item we got here. So I guess it's truly not bad. I'm just, it's like some clickbait bullshit, but it doesn't do anything for us except guarantee us the win, which I guess is why I considered it bad. The 3 Spirit Arts basically mean that we'll have whatever HP we have going into the boss fight plus 3, and then times 9 lives. We won't have the HP for 9 lives, but, you know, we'll have 9 lives after that with which to hopefully not throw it completely. Stay as far away as we can, let the flies and spiders do their damage, or better yet, let us do the damage and the spiders can come through to the next room and hopefully do even more damage to other enemies. Card Against Humanity's, it's a bit of an interesting one. I don't mind this damage at all. I sort of am starting to mind that damage. Please. We have so many flies and spiders. One of them then could have done some damage. I wouldn't have been too mad about it. Okay, this guy's gonna, yep, he's gonna explode. So we gotta be cool about this one. This is probably the right time for us to take the Rosary. Don't rush me. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna go back and take the Rosary. If this is the right way. Now I've forgotten. Curse of the Lost actually constructively tore me apart a little bit here. Yeah, let's go this way. I know that we've already gone like 90% of the way in the other direction. I like to mix it up, you know, see if we can get as many items as possible. Okay, we've almost lost all the HP from the Rosary. I feel like a little bit of an idiot. All we gotta do is beat Blue Baby once. That's the thing. He's gotta beat us 9 times. We only gotta beat him once. It's really unfair for him, actually. He should submit a complaint to Edmund, I think. It's not not conducive to his success. Easy. I'm kind of surprised we haven't had any treasure chests drop, but, you know, shit happens, I suppose. Thank you. And stay away. Thank you as well. No treasure chests. I mean, at this point, I don't think we can really justify needing the bombs. Even though we do have sad bombs. Thank you. This is... I kind of wish that you'd left that half hard, but maybe this will be just enough to get you to pay out twice. Just once? That's all right. You got to be close to twice, then. The haunts. Let's try using some sad bombs. I mean, we got 46 of them. Let's throw one down, like, right here. That's pretty good. I mean, we have a lot of damage, so it makes sense. Good stuff. This is proving to be the wrong direction again, but I like this. I like exploring all of the chests for the chance to get free items. Let's throw a bomb down here. I wonder if this will kill them all. The shots are incredibly low range and slow shot speed, but they do a lot of damage if they hit. I want this, actually. This one's for me. I need that half-heart interval, or I would like to have this half-heart interval. I think we've checked to the left, so we're just going to go down. No, I don't know where I've ended up. No, this is the right way, yeah. So we're going to go down, and I think we're just going to continue on the path. No, we're going to go in a completely different direction, actually. for reasons unbeknownst to me. I'm just a passenger in my own body, you know, I just... My brain and body do things, and then it's just, you know, Northern Lion here going, oh, that's a weird one, I don't know why I did that, it seems like kind of a silly decision in hindsight. Maybe to the right? Have we been to the right? No, lots of branching paths in here. Throw some bomb down occasionally. You know, I think our sad bombs might actually help us do quite a lot of damage here. I hate these enemies, and it worked out actually kind of alright. Missing page. No thank you. That's not missing page. Mysterious paper. It's amazing you can be so close yet so far away. They're I know missing page and mysterious paper are both, in my mind, nearly identically useless. So that is how everything gets shuffled into the trash part of my brain. We really don't need those keys at this point. It's just getting a little ridiculous, to be honest with you. Bob's Curse? I thought we already had... No, that was last run. We had Bob's Curse on the last run. Okay. Now, I did take a lot of damage against Isaac. I would rather not replicate that against Blue Baby. Hopefully we can get some spirit arts here. I do think that we're going to win. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, hey, the spiders are friendly, so I appreciate it. I'm going to throw down some bombs whenever we can, because they're actually going to do a nice little bit of damage. Now, I think the thing that killed me on the Blue Baby run... Oh, geez, get out of there. Or on the Isaac run, I should say, was just, like, too much damage consistently. Like, I would take damage, and then I'd try to, you know, double or nothing to get out of there, and it just wouldn't work. So what I'm trying to do now is just keep it as safe, consistent as possible. If you get hit, you know, move away because you're clearly in a dangerous position. And that'll do it right there. So we're going to reroll our whole run. Just see if we get what we get. What do we, you know, that would have been pretty cool. I'll allow it. I don't think we got the D100 there because that would have been our space bar. And I guess that doesn't even work to begin with. But anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.